Modifying images inserted into a workbook. Images or pictures have a habit of being larger than we often want them to be, especially after we insert them into a worksheet. Once that happens, we may want to move them elsewhere or possibly even remove them. Or we may want to make modifications to them so they fit better. So now we'll go through the changes you can make to such images to make them try to work better on your sheet. A useful tool when working with images is the picture toolbar, shown here. Available when you open the View menu, select Toolbars, and then select Picture. Remember that any checked toolbar listings here are open already on the desktop. When you insert an image, the picture bar usually opens for your use. You can rotate an image, you can compress pictures, you can crop, you can format the picture itself, you can reset the picture, set a transparent color for the picture, adjust color, or contrast or brightness, things like that. Also, let's talk a little bit more so that you understand a few more things. And please note that the picture toolbar should open automatically if you click on an image you've inserted into your workbook. For example, if it doesn't open automatically once you've inserted the workbook, just clicking on the image should show the picture toolbar for you. One type of modification you can do to an image is to crop it, which means to trim unnecessary material from the edges of an image to make it look better or to better fit a space. For this, we're going to go to the picture toolbar and we're going to click on the crop icon. Notice that handles appear at the edges of the image window. And from these we can make adjustments. For example, we can click up here and drag it down a bit. We can click over here and use our mouse to drag it in a bit. We can also move the image on the screen by pointing on the image and then just dragging it around. Here's an interesting point too. Just because you crop an image doesn't mean that the image file itself, that is, the space it takes on your hard drive, shrinks. The file size never shrinks from cropping. You probably want to avoid inserting a picture with a very large file size, such as 1 megabyte or more, would normally be considered quite excessive, especially if the image isn't really necessary for the worksheet. However, you can find and download graphic conversion programs that can take a large file size format and convert that image into another format that can cut the file size dramatically. You can also format the picture for presentation. To do this, you can either go to the picture bar and choose Format Picture, or you can point to the image, right-click, and choose Format Picture. You'll notice that the Format Picture window opens. You can set colors and lines and how you want things to be. You can adjust the size and rotate from here and set the scale or change the scale. You can crop from specific areas. You can adjust image control for color, brightness, and contrast. Set up protection, whether it's locked into the cell. Properties, such as whether object positioning can be done where they can move but not size the cells, or they can't move or size the cells. And also alternative text. For example, if you're publishing this to a web page, you would want to type in alternative text, which would be displayed if for some reason the person who's viewing the web page, either because of a visual handicap or because there's something with their software, they cannot actually view the picture, they'll receive a text message telling them what the picture is. So that's important. When you're done selecting options for formatting the picture, you can click OK. Now, to remove an image you've added, you can simply point to the image here, and while you can choose other options such as cut to move it somewhere else or copy to move it somewhere else, you can just click the delete key on your keyboard and it disappears like that. If you undo or remove an image you didn't intend to remove, go to the edit window, click undo clear.